PFT, the Capitals. Yes. I have a question for you. Who?
No, I'm not worried.
Who is? No, that's not the question. Who's more to blame for the Capitals going to seven games against the Carolina Hurricanes? One, bad boy Ovechkin getting kicked out of the game, slashing guys, beating up teenagers. Or two, cocky PFT who has been making plans all over the office for every single round after this one in the Capitals playoffs.
Three, the refs.
It's not Ovechkin because the things that you mentioned, the slashing, the getting kicked out, that was in the last like 3 seconds of the game. So I'm going to go out on a limb and saying that the plus minus after Ovechkin got kicked out of the game being zero leads me to believe that it wasn't his fault. I will say the refs, as I predicted, you guys were probably all over me being like, oh, PFT, oh, you're making plans to go to Toronto. Oh, PFT, you're making plans to go out to Las Vegas again. Well, guess what? That's what champions do, okay? I'm a champion.
Hold on.
Hank knows about it. I'm allowed to look past the Carolina Hurricanes. Listen, this is the District of Champions right now. I don't get out of bed for first round playoff hockey series anymore. I'm going full on mass hole. This is my championship team that I'm dealing with here, okay? So, it's not my fault. I predicted Caps in two. As I said on the last show, it's a three-game series, and it's still a chance for Caps in two because the refs took game six. So the Caps are 1-0 from game five on. I'm very confident the Carolina tropical storms are about to be in deep depression, and I'm not worried at all.
Okay, so you answered my question. Cocky PFT is the worst.
Absolutely.
You came up to me and you're like, hey, Thursday we might have to go to D.C. for game one against the Islanders. And I was like, isn't there game six tonight? And you're like, well,
yeah,
whatever.
Listen,
and then you see what happens.
Here's what's happening right now. In my tiny little pea brain, I'm trying to rationalize my deepest fear of the Caps losing the first round through overconfidence. And I'm not like Hank. I'm not a Boston Massole sports fan. I'm not used to championships. I have one. And I really enjoyed that one, and I would very much like another, and I'm rooting very hard for the team, and I am worried. I'm very worried about what can happen in Game 7. As we heard from Kevin Millar, Game 7, anything can happen.
That was kind of a team of destiny to get out of that goal last night by the Hurricanes.
Yeah, this is good. We're stripping it down. This is a analysis of PFT here. The cocky PFT was a charade. It was a coat of armor. We've taken it away. You're worried. That's okay. That's a normal feeling to have. And Game 7 on Wednesday night will define whether the Caps are a dynasty in the making or just a blip on the radar, a one-year, whoops, what happened in that year? No one even remembers the Capitals won the Cup.
Yeah, because everybody got too drunk afterwards. The whole team was hungover for an entire summer, so they wouldn't remember that. But I'm cautiously optimistic. As I said, I am worried, but there's reason to believe, number one, that entire goal being taken I guess it wasn't taken off the boards because they never awarded it, but it was very clearly a goal that should have counted. The fact that it didn't, I think, will fire the team up a little bit. That was the turning point of the game, no question about it. And the fact that we beat them 6-0 last time we were in our barn, the legendary MCI Center, that gives me reason to believe, too. And I just want to say, we haven't really discussed stadium montages this postseason that much, as any longtime listener would know. I'm a huge fan of the time-lapse stadium montage when they're changing it from hockey to basketball back to hockey. It's cool. It's like, I thought that was a hockey arena. Oh, my God, there's wood now. I really enjoy it. I'm pissed off. That's the thing I'm most pissed off, I think, at the Wizards for is just the fact that they haven't given me any good stadium montages in the last, like, 4 or 5 years. They've been so shitty as a team that I haven't even gotten that one little bit of joy out of them. Mm-hmm. So it's the stadium montage, the handshake line. No matter what happens in Game 7, we're getting a handshake line, so there's that to look forward to.